Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. So I've been wanting to try out a couple of new stitches lately, but I didn't know what to make with them. So today we're going to be making this really cute and simple beginner friendly clutch with two new stitches, the bead stitch and the link double crochet. The link double crochet is great because it has absolutely no holes. So if you're planning to use this stitch for a baby blanket as well, that's a great idea. So let's get started. So here are all the supplies I'm going to be using for my project. For this project, I'm going to be using Kartopu Pure Viscose. This is a really fun yarn to work with. If you look at it, it almost has a rope-like texture. It's extremely soft. And the best part about it is when you're working with it, it doesn't split at all because it's all woven into a single string like this. So I just want to show you what it looks like on the inside. So if you look at it, it's got the fabric on the outside and it's got a little bit of stuffing on the inside. So it's a really soft, very fun yarn to work with. Here are the details of the yarn. So if you see, it calls for a 5mm crochet hook, but because I tend to crochet extremely loose, I'm going to be going in with a G hook or a 4mm crochet hook. You also need a pair of scissors, a yarn needle, and I have these little wooden beads that I picked up from a craft store that I'm going to be using as well. So before we get started, I just wanted to explain the pattern to you. So for this project, we'll be working it in two parts. Part one is going to be the top portion of the bag, which we're going to be doing in the bead stitch. And this is going to be about 8 inches. You can make it any size you want depending on what you want to make. If you want to turn this into a laptop sleeve, you can always make it a little longer. The second part is going to be the bottom part, which we're going to be doing in a much tighter stitch with no holes. That's called the linked double crochet. And this is going to be exactly double of what you did initially. So in my case, it's going to be 16 inches. And then what we'll be doing is we'll be folding this up in half and then creating a purse that way. So now in order to get started, we're going to start with a slip knot. So make a loop with your yarn. With the tail end, make another loop inside of the first one. Just pick it up and pull. Now you're going to insert your hook into this and just tighten. Now we're going to start by chaining an odd number of chains. So I'm going to start by chaining 35. So to create a chain, you just yarn over and pull through. And you do this as many times as you want, depending on how large you want your clutch to be. So I'm going to finish my 35 chains and then I'll show you how to proceed. Now once I'm done with my 35 chains, we're going to start our first row, and our first row is going to be a row of single crochets. So we're going to skip the first stitch, go into the second stitch and place a single crochet. So insert your hook, yarn over, you have two loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through two. Again into the next one, insert your hook, yarn over, pull up a loop, two loops on the hook, yarn over, pull through two. And continue this all the way around until the end of this row. So if you see, I've come to the end of my row of single crochets. I just wanted to show you there's a last stitch right here that most people forget to work into. So don't forget that one. Insert your hook into that stitch right there and place a single crochet. So that completes your row. Now we're going to chain three. One, two, three, and we're going to turn our work over. We're going to skip this first stitch and place a double crochet into the second stitch, which is right here. So to place a double crochet, yarn over, insert your hook into that second stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through two. So we've placed a double crochet right here, and if you see, there's a space in between these two. We're going to be working into that space to create a bead. So you're going to yarn over, go into that space behind the double crochet and pull through. Again, yarn over, go behind that space and pull through One more time, yarn over, go behind that space and pull through. So now if we count the number of stitches, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We're going to yarn over and pull through 6 of these. So that's 5 and 6. And now we have 2 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through 2. So if you see, we've created our first bead. Now we're going to skip the next stitch, which is this one. And into the one after that, we're going to place a double crochet again. Now into this space in between, we're going to create a bead. Yarn over, go behind the double crochet, pull through, yarn over, behind the double crochet, pull through, yarn over, behind the double crochet, pull through. You have 7 loops on the hook. Yarn over, pull through 6 of these loops. Oops. And now you have 2 loops left. Yarn over, pull through 2. And this is how your bead stitch looks. Let's do that one more time. Skip the next stitch, place a double crochet on the one after that. I'll show you a little closer now. Yarn over, go behind, pull through. That's the first one. Yarn over, go behind again. That's the second one. Yarn over, go behind, and that's the third one. Now yarn over and just make sure you're pulling through all the stitches, and you'll pull through until you have 2 on the hook. Then you just yarn over and pull through. So this is how the bead stitch looks. It's a very pretty 3D sort of stitch. So go on and complete until the end of the row, and I'll show you how to finish this row up. So again, to give you a quick recap of the pattern, you're going to skip the next stitch, place a double crochet into the one after that, and then work into that space by inserting your hook behind the stitch 3 times, yarning over and pulling through until you have 7 loops on your hook. When you have 7 loops on your hook, you're going to yarn over, pull through 6 of these 7 loops, and then yarn over and pull through the last 2. So continue this until the end. So I just completed a bead right here, and now I have 2 stitches left. We're going to skip the next stitch. Into the last stitch, we're just going to place a double crochet, and that completes this row. Just remember, when you're doing the last stitch over here, you're not going to create a bead. It's just going to be a double crochet, and you'll end with that. Now we're going to chain 1 and turn. And for the next row, we're just going to place 1 single crochet all the way around until the end. So this pattern is really simple. You'll basically be doing 1 row of single crochets followed by 1 row of the beads. Once we're done with this row of single crochets, I'll show you the row of beads one more time. So now that I've placed 1 single crochet until the end of this row, we're going to start with the chain of 3. Turn the work around, skip this first stitch, go into the second, place a double crochet, and then create a bead. Again, skip a stitch, go into the next one, place a double crochet, and then do your bead again. So now you're going to continue rows 2 and 3 until you reach 8 inches in length, and make sure that you end on a row of single crochets. So now I've completed about 18 rows, and I love the way this pattern looks. If I just measure it, it comes to around 8 inches right now, and I like this size. So now what we're going to do is we're going to make another 16 inches, but of a different stitch. So now for the rest of my project, I wanted something that doesn't have big holes in it, because that's how the bead stitch is. It has pretty large holes and I don't really want to line this project. So we're going to be doing a linked double crochet. So to do a linked double crochet, you're going to start with a chain of 2, 1, 2, and you're going to turn your work around. Now you're going to insert your hook into that second chain. So if you see, there's a chain 1, chain 2. We're going to go inside of the chain 2, pull up a loop, then go into the next stitch, which is right here, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. So that completes our first double crochet. Now we're going to start with the second double crochet, and if you see, there's a bar right here underneath this stitch, which is right here. We're going to be working into this. So insert your hook into the bar, pull up a loop, go into the next stitch, pull up a loop. You have 3 loops on the hook, pull through 2, pull through 2. Now we do that again. There's the bar right here. Insert your hook into the bar, pull up a loop, go into the next stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. And this is the pattern you'll be following all the way until the end. So again, insert your hook into the bar, pull up a loop, insert into the next stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. So if you look at it, there are no gaps in between your stitches now. There's no space in between, and it's a pretty tight stitch and it looks really, really good. So we'll do that one more time together. Go into the bar, pull up a loop, go into the next stitch, pull up a loop, and then do a double crochet. So this is a linked double crochet. Complete until the end of the row and I'll show you how to start the next row. So now we finished a whole row of linked double crochets. I love how this looks against the bead stitch. So let's start with the next row. You're going to chain 2, turn your work around. Now we're going to start the same way. We're going to go into the second chain. So skip the first chain, go into the second chain, which is right here. Pull up a loop, go into the second stitch, which is right here. Pull up a loop, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2. Now again, we're going to go into the next stitch right here, yarn over, go into the stitch after that, pull up a loop, pull up a loop. Go into the bar underneath, yarn over, into the next stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, pull up a loop. And this is the pattern we're going to follow all the way around until the remaining rows. So basically, you'll have to measure how much you've made this portion, double it up, and then make the rest of your clutch, because we'll be folding this through. So once you're done with the rest of the rows, come back and meet me back here again and I'll show you how to stitch the sides and finish your clutch. So now that I've finished a couple of rows, I just want you to measure before I finish up my project. So if I look at it, it comes to about 16 inches for the bottom portion, and then the top, as we measured before, is about 8 inches, which is perfect. So I'm just going to finish up the very last stitch of my last row, which is right here. And now you just need to find the right side. So if you see, I had to change yarn, so I had to tie up my yarn over here. So this side is what I want to go on the inside, and the other side is the clean side, which I want to go on the outside. So now when I start sewing my sides together, I'm going to flip it over to the bad side and then just fold this in half like so. So now that I folded this in half, I'm just going to line it to the topmost row, and then I'm going to slip stitch my way through the sides, through the front and the back, to sew the two ends together. So I'll show you how to do that. Just line up your rows right here. your hook is already on the last stitch over here. So you're just going to insert your hook onto the first stitch of the back side, yarn over and pull through. So you're doing a slip stitch. Go into the next stitch, front and back, yarn over, pull through, front and back, pull through, and you're going to place slip stitches this way all the way around the two sides. So complete this side, and when you get to the bottom, I'll show you how to proceed. So now once you've reached the bottom, what you could do is you could snip the yarn off and then start again on the other side. What I like to do is, just to give the bag a little more definition, I like to continue my slip stitches across the bottom as well. So to do that, I'm just going to go through each of these bottom stitches, and then just in that last row, take the front and back and continue placing slip stitches across. So I'll do a few and show you what it looks like. So let's do two more. So if you see, it gives it a nice little border across the bottom as well. Once you reach the other side, you can continue all the way until the top. And once you finish it, I'll show you how to attach the button. Now I've completed going around all the three sides. At the end, we're just going to chain one, leave a tail for sewing in, and then just snip the yarn off and pull it through. Now you can sew in the ends and make sure to put it towards the inside of the bag so it's not visible on the outside. So now this is how your little clutch looks. You can just fold over the top, and this is the way it is. Now we're going to add a little bead or a button over here, so then we can close this. So the first thing you do is count the number of puffs that you have on the bottom. So for me, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. So I'm going to count 9 on one side, 9 on the other side, and find the middlemost one. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And this is the 10th one. So I basically want my bead to be placed right here. So when it closes, it looks like this. So now to sew my bead on, I've just threaded on a little bit of the string. I'm just going to put the bead through like so. Find that middle spot, which for me is right here, and then just sew the bead on really simply. So now once you've sewn your little bead on, it's really simple to close your bag. All you need to do is pull it through the middle of the two beads like this, and your little clutch is ready. Now if you want to make this a crossbody bag, you can always just attach a row of single crochets all the way across to create a handle. I just like it the way it is. And here's the final clutch all ready. This is the back side. If you see, it's solid enough, so then the contents of your bag are not visible. And the front has this gorgeous lacy pattern and a little button to close it up. If you enjoyed watching this video, please like the video and share it with all your friends. Subscribe to my channel. And until next time, bye-bye.